नमः ओम विष्णुपादाय कृष्ण प्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्ति वेदांता स्वामिन्निति नामिने नमस्ते सारस्वते देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्य देश तारिणे। हरे कृष्णा एवरीवन। सो वी आर इन द मिडल ऑफ डिस्कसिंग श्लोका नंबर 68। यस्टरडे वी डिस्कस्ड एक्चुअल मीनिंग ऑफ द श्लोका एंड आई प्रॉमिस्ड यू आई विल शेयर टू नाइस एग्जाम्पल। सो लेट्स डाइव इन टू देम। सो दिस इंसिडेंट आई हर्ड फ्रॉम सम प्रीचर दैट आई नो। सो ही वॉज सेइंग हाउ व्हेन ही वॉज अ यंग बॉय देर वॉज अ मूवी। ही वॉज फ्रॉम अ विलेज। So, you know, there is this tent and once in a while the movies would be played there. And there was one very nice Tamil movie that was played there and he wanted to watch it. So he went to his grandpa and said, "Grandpa, grandpa, there is this nice movie that's come to town and I want to watch it." Grandpa said, "No, you can't go." And those were the days where once no means no. It's not like grandpa said no, then you go to mom and ask. Mom says no, you go to dad and ask. That was not the culture then. So then, although he didn't like the answer, he just kept quiet and went about his routine things. After about 3 days, the same grandfather who refused to let him go watch the movie, he proactively called the grandson. And he said, "You know, you were talking about that movie that has come to town." He said, "You go watch. And that neighboring friend of yours, you take him also along. Here is the money." He said, "There is a little bit extra money. From this, you buy some snacks also and you eat and enjoy and then come back." So, of course, he was happy. So, he went with his friend, watched the movie, everything was nice. But again, the culture was such that he was so fearful of his grandfather, out of respect, of course. So he didn't muster the courage to ask, "Why is it just 3 days ago when he wanted to go watch, grandpa said no? And now he himself is calling and sending." He said, in fact, actually, until he got to college and then he was working and all that, he couldn't really muster the courage. Many, many years later, in fact, decades later, he said, he asked the grandfather, "So this one thing you clarify, why is it that you waited for 3 days and then you let me watch the movie?" So grandpa, smiling, answered, "That was to teach you a lesson about controlling your senses, controlling your mind. Just because something came to your mind, something you felt like doing, something you felt like eating, it doesn't mean you always have to, you know, indulge in that. You should learn to at times take your senses away. You should learn at times to control your mind." And when I saw that you were able to do that, when I said no, you didn't even, you know, come back and be forceful about it. You did not insist. So 3 days later, it was a reward for you to control, for controlling your senses. So such wonderful parenting, actually. I don't know how many more such wonderful lessons he was taught just through incidences like this, and I think we are greatly missing out on such things. And why this example? It goes to show how much important sense control is, mind control is. And yet another classic example from Mahabharata is about Maharaja Bharat, after whom our great country is called Bharatavarsha. So Maharaja Bharat was not just a king, he was an emperor of the entire planet. The India that we know today, Bharatavarsha, we know today is not what you see in the map. Entire world was Bharatavarsha. So he had conquered the entire world and then he is coming back and everybody is praising his glories, what a great king he is. And then his minister, in confidence, reminds him that Maharaja Bharat, "I think it's about time that you should announce your heir apparent, who is going to be after you." So Maharaja Bharat becomes poignant and he is confused. He has 9 sons, not just one. But somehow he does not have the clarity as to whom he has to appoint as his heir. So he goes to Kanva Maharshi, who happens to be the foster father of his mother Shakuntala. So he goes and, you know, with due respects and all that, he presents this question in front of him. "So who should I appoint as my heir?" And Kanva Maharshi, with a smile on his face, tells Maharaja Bharat, looks like the king who has conquered all the countries, all the kingdoms, has still not conquered himself. And he says, go work on your self-realization. The day you conquer yourself, then the answer will become evident in your heart. So Maharaja Bharat comes and he does some intense tapasya, and then he achieves self-realization. And then, with not an ounce of attachment, he realizes that none of his 9 sons are qualified to be the next king. None. So with utmost clarity and with no doubt at all in his mind, he appoints Bhumanyu, the son of one of his citizens, as the next heir. And Shakuntala, his mother, is so saddened by this news that he calls Maharaja Bharat in private and he says, I think in the history of the world, you are the first father who has done such injustice towards his own sons. And when asked like that, Maharaja Bharat tells her, that I'm not just a father, but I'm also a responsible king. And as a king, I don't have just 9 sons, but all my citizens are my sons. And I have to do what is right. And a king has to be chosen not based on birth, but based on karma, qualification, not janma, but karma. And Bhumanyu has it. Such high caliber. Of course, unfortunately, from that kind of king, Maharaja Bharat, it came down to Dhritarashtra, who had so much of Putra Moha and became all about Janma and not Karma. But again, I shared this example of Maharaja Bharat to drive the point across about sense control. That Indriya Nigraha, that control of mind, not having that false attachment. All these are very essential and we have to imbibe these qualities, and that is why Krishna keeps bringing it up again and again. So if we have to become a Sthita Prajna, sense control is a must and should. So that is what we have discussed in this shloka. In the next video, very, very beautiful, important shloka coming up, shloka number 69. So I know you can't wait for it. It's just another day. We'll be back with the next video. So until then, take care. Hare Krishna.